Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord hath said unto me, Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. Why do the kingdoms of the earth rage together, and why so the people imagine the main thing? Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord hath said unto me, Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our judge, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
The epistle for the feast of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ is taken from the book of Titus, chapter 2, beginning at verse 11. The grace of God, which bringeth salvation, hath appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, looking for that blessed hope, and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. These things speak and exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no man despise thee. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
In the day of thy power shall the people offer thee freewill offerings with an holy worship. The dew of thy birth is of the womb of the morning. The Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou on my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord said unto me, thou art my son. This day have I begotten thee. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, and into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that when they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in that same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock at night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in a swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with an angel the multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Thus far the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Stay together as individual family groups and come up, you might do. for communion, that would be perfect. You can feel free to kneel or stand, whatever you prefer, for the reception of Holy Communion. We have a service of Holy Communion tomorrow at 10 a.m. here at the church for Christmas Day. We also have Holy Communion Saturday for St. Stephen, and Monday for the Holy Innocents, all Prayer Book Holy Days. I think that is it as far as announcements. Are there any other announcements that need to be made? If we want to increase our ventilation, you know, we could open this back door and just leave that open. And Tom, there's actually, if you maybe want to open that window in the parish hall there, right by the steps, I think there's a screen in it. Otherwise, we'd be surrounded by moths, but they like to celebrate Christmas too, I guess. So that'll give us some more ventilation. And I think that's it. Are there any other announcements that need to be made? Okay, well, at this time, I want to introduce someone very special to me, a man who has been a longtime friend, a mentor, and just an all-around help. A man who is a Marine, who gave up a lucrative career in the insurance industry to offer his life for the sacred priesthood. That man is none other than Father Don Edelman, my dear friend and colleague. He will be preaching for us tonight, and I will be preaching for us tomorrow. Father?
Well, this is the first. I'm not talking about the preaching, but I'm talking that someone besides the audience muffled me, you know. Maybe I can still get through to you. O tidings of comfort and joy. O tidings of comfort and joy. Hymnal number 40. That is what I'm speaking about tonight. You are all aware of the fact that we have to sit here masked. We have to strategically distance ourselves. Life is not the same as it was 12 months ago on this night. And a lot of us feel down. A lot of us feel uncomfortable. A lot of us feel worried. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. The birth of our Lord gave us comfort, gave us joy that we knew that a Savior was born to us this night. O tidings of comfort and joy. You know, you see on the TV, all these people are having mental problems or getting very uptight with what they have to go through. I may be wrong, but I say baloney. For one big reason, this night our Savior was born. Take comfort in that. If you follow your life as our Savior commanded you, what have you to fear except fear itself? And take great joy. Be joyful that our Lord was set down here by his Father to forgive our sins because he knew of our frailty. He came down here to guide us, to be a shoulder to lean on, someone we can look to and pray to and say, Lord, save me, I am a sinner. Please let me come unto you, whiter than snow. Oh, glad tidings of comfort and joy. You know, a lot of people don't like this carol because they make it seem like it's a bunch of guys getting together with drinks and the pentam of the music itself comes close to a drinking song. Well, drink could probably help giving you comfort, but I don't know how much joy it's going to give, especially the next morning. But we sit here tonight expecting this wonderful birth that is coming, this wonderful gift that God is bringing us so that we may all be sinless in his eyes if we follow our Lord Jesus Christ. And not just follow him this Christmas night or tomorrow during Christmas Day, but follow him throughout the year. It's one thing the church does. Throughout the year, it gives you a lesson. It gives you a formula to go through the life of Christ before his crucifixion and his restoring himself to us. He died for our sins. He died so that our sins may be washed away. How much comfort is that? What else can you get that comfort from? I hate to name the ways. A lot of it is out there. And it's very illegal. And it does nothing to help you. What helps you if you feel a little uptight and if you feel like the world is against you? Just get down on your knees. Say hello to Jesus. And say hello to God. And thank them both for coming in your life so that you may receive the blessings of Christ and of God. So that you may be joyful that you have this avenue to save you and help you. Be not sad this evening. Be full of joy. Be comfortable. Feel the Lord is here with you. Let him take you by the hand. Let him say, travail no more, my friend. I am here to guide you to my Father. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad before the Lord, for he is come. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive this sacrifice at my hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church. Amen.
We beseech thee, O Lord, that the oblation of this day's festival may be acceptable unto thee, that by thy bountiful grace we may, through this holy communion, be found in the likeness of him in whom our substance is united to thee, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake. Our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, Judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings, the remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him.
Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood.
Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make. Having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. Here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee.
Father, Lord, Spirit, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for me, preserved. was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving.
Thus assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that
by godly conversation be found worthy to attain to fellowship with him, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit liveth and reigneth God, the world without end.
Amen.
O God, who hast made this most holy night to shine with the brightness of the true light, grant, we beseech thee, that we who have known the mysteries of his life on earth may attain unto the fruition of his joys in heaven, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit liveth and reigneth God, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Yeah.